Are you looking for an easy, no-code solution for building AI chatbots and adding them to WhatsApp? Today, we're diving straight into creating a WhatsApp AI chatbot using Vectorshift. If you're new to Vectorshift, it's a no-code platform that makes it stupidly easy to create AI chatbots and advanced AI agents. In this video, we'll speed run the process of creating an AI chatbot and then integrate it into WhatsApp. I already have plenty of videos showing how to create different types of chatbots using Vectorshift, so today we'll focus specifically on the WhatsApp integration. Let's get started. As per usual, head over to Vectorshift.ai and log in or click on Get Started to create your account, and you will be able to use the free tier to follow along. After signing in, click on Pipelines and then click on New. Let's then click on Create Pipeline from Scratch. In this video, we'll create a very simple chatbot, but you can use the same technique to create RAG chatbots and AI agents. Let's add an input node as well as an output node. Then let's also add an LLM and let's add the OpenAI node, like so. Let's attach the input node to the prompt input on the LLM, and let's pass the response of the LLM to the output node. Let's add a very simple system message just to give our LLM a bit of a personality, like your name is Max, include emojis in your responses. Now, of course, you can go way further by attaching knowledge bases and advanced functionality to your chatbot, but I want to move on to the WhatsApp integration. Let's quickly test this chatbot by running the pipeline. Let's switch to chatbot and let's say hello. And we do get a response back showing that our chatbot is working. Now let's first give our pipeline a name. So I'll simply call mine WhatsApp Demo. On the top right, let's click on Deploy Changes. Then let's click on Export Pipeline and let's select Chatbot. Let's give the chatbot a name. So I'll call mine WhatsApp Demo and let's click on Create Chatbot. You should now be presented with this screen where you can customize your chatbot. If you don't see the screen, then you can go back to your dashboard and then click on Chatbots. Let's double click on the chatbot to continue editing it. Now feel free to customize this chatbot if you want, but for WhatsApp, this doesn't really matter. Let's go to Export and let's open up this Twilio section over here. But before we go over to Twilio, we do need to create a Vectorshift API key. So let's actually do that now. Under Personal, go to Profile, then click on API Keys and click on Generate Key. Let's give our key a name like WhatsApp Chatbot and let's click on Generate. Let's copy this key and then simply store it somewhere for the time being, like in Notepad. Let's go to Chatbots. Let's open up our chatbot. Let's click on Export, Twilio Configuration. And now that we have our API key, we can go ahead and set up Twilio. So go over to twilio.com and click on Start for Free. Go ahead and sign up for an account or sign into your existing account. Either way, you will be presented with this dashboard. If you scroll down to the account info section, you can see your account SID and an auth token. Let's copy the SID and back in Vectorshift, let's paste it into this field. Then let's do the same for the auth token and let's also add it to Vectorshift. Now let's copy this Twilio webhook URL like so, and back in Twilio, let's go to Messaging, try it out, and send a WhatsApp message. On this screen, click on Sandbox Settings, and within this When a Message Comes In field, paste in the URL that you just copied. Within this URL, we simply have to replace this section within the curly braces with our API key we generated earlier. So let's paste that into the URL. Let's click on Sandbox, and all you have to do now is send a WhatsApp message to this number, and the message should contain this text. So I'm going to try that now. Let's send the message, join brown finger, like so. And now I do receive a message from Twilio. Great. We should now be able to chat with our AI assistant. So let's try that out. Let's send hello. And look at that, we get a response back. Let's ask, what is your name, and of course our system message is working as well. Now, once you're ready to move your chatbot out of sandbox to production, I highly recommend having a look at the Vectorshift documentation, which I will link in the description of this video. And this really involves verifying your business by using this verification form over here. If you enjoyed this video, then please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more Vectorshift content. Also, check out these other videos on Vectorshift over here. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.